Hello, folks. Kel Kellogg here. Seems like I haven't come to you from my backyard in forever. I traveled to Florida. When I got back, I went out with Kevin Brock on Lake Oroville. Then I spent some time out on the ocean. Long story short, I haven't been trout fishing in several weeks, and I haven't had the kayak out in several weeks. But I wanted to talk to you about it's not a new trout lure, but it's a new trout lure to me, and I'll bet it's a new trout lure to you, too. Now, you saw the title on this video, Catching Trout on Eels, and I'm not talking about the slimy live eels like, you know, guys back east used to catch stripers. I'm talking about an eel spoon from Thomas Lures, and these are the same folks that bring us the Thomas Buoyant and, of course, the Speedy Shiner. Now, for a long time, years, I've been looking at their website, and I kept seeing this spoon called the Eel. Yeah, that's what it's called, the Eel. So, anyway, I've been seeing this spoon, and I was always intrigued by it, but I'd never seen one in the store. So, finally, I just called them up. I said, hey, you got a bunch of stuff on your website. I'm not seeing it in stores. What's the deal? I want to try them out. And Peter Ridd, he's the owner up there back in Pennsylvania, he sent me a bunch of Colorado spoons and different things to play with, which I have been playing with a little bit, but as I said, I haven't been out in the water a great deal, but that's going to change. But he sent me some eel spoons, and let me show you what they look like. They come in two different sizes. Here's one in the package. This is a small size. Kind of see it there. And I'm going to show you one out of the package, one I actually been playing with a little bit. And here's a gold one. That's in the small size, too. That's what the package looks like. But I got one on a spinning rod here. And I was actually down at the river the other day goofing around with this lure. And I shot some footage of it in the water. And before I show it to you, I'll talk a little bit about the action. I like lures with a lot of action. And a lot of times I like lures with a slim profile. And that's what you see with the eel. It has tremendous action. Probably seeing it right now. I got to edit that in. I'll run it by fast and then I'll slow it down. What you see there is a ton of action, a lot of wiggle. It's putting out a whole bunch of vibration, and I think it's going to be a fish killer. So let's check out the large version. And I think this one weighs, if I'm not mistaken, I got it all tangled up here. I think this one weighs a quarter ounce, and this is the one you just saw running in the water. And set my rod down. Here it is. It's the silver version. It's a couple inches long. Look at the curve in that lure. That's just got a very aggressive curve. There it is on top profile. It's got two eyes on it like a real eel. But it's just got an aggressive curve. And when you saw it running in the video, I've just got it hooked on a small lock snap, and that is 10-pound or 8-pound test fluorocarbon line. But saw a lot of action, a lot of wiggle, a lot of flash, a lot of vibration. This is pretty heavy. I would say this is a quarter ounce or more. So you can cast this thing a long distance. The smaller ones, I believe they weigh about an eighth of an ounce. So I would say in terms of casting, this is a very similar lure to a Castmaster or a Crocodile. I just snapped that off the snap. Let me put that back on there. This is very similar to a Castmaster or a Crocodile in terms of its casting ability. You can cast it, you can troll it. And since I was on the bank playing with it, I don't know about the speed in miles per hour, but what I did notice was I could run it slow and get a lot of action. I could pull it really fast and get a lot of action. So I suspect when I get out on the water that this is a lure I'm going to be able to troll fast, medium, or slow. And that's awesome. Anytime you have a spoon that you can run across multiple speeds, especially when you're fishing out of a kayak and, you know, you're kind of controlling the speed with your ability to pedal, that's awesome. So I'm really looking forward to getting out and trolling this. Probably going to take it up to French Meadows and play with them a little bit, because that's a place I know where the trout are. I know I can catch trout up there, and pretty sure they're going to really like the eel. So if you're looking to try something new, looking to experiment a little bit, go on a Thomas Lures website, check out the eels, and look around on the web. You'll find a source for them. And at this point, without having actually fished with it, I highly recommend it. It's just an intriguing lure. Look at that aggressive bend one more time. So anyway, the eel, get out there, get a few eel, and see what the trout think. I can tell you, I think the trout are going to respond favorably to this lure. So anyway, I can't wait to get out on the water and give them a try. Anyway, this is Kel Kellogg. I'm signing off, and I'll catch you again here real soon on YouTube. Please hit that subscribe button if you haven't, and I really want to thank you folks for all the support. We're back in the saddle again. I'm back from Florida. I'm done saltwater fishing for at least a couple weeks, and it's going to be all about trout fishing, salmon fishing in our lakes, and trout and salmon fishing content. So anyway, folks, I will catch you again real soon.